Here we are.
Here we are!
Picture a hot dog bun and throw all the stars, the hundreds of stars that there are in the universe, into a bag, and put the universe into a bag, and you, all of a sudden, they become,
Hey everybody, this is John Anthony from John Anthony Lifestyle, and today I want to talk about getting over a breakup the fastest way in 2019. So the quickest way, neurologically speaking, from a cold, callous standpoint, is you want to delete all memories of the girl, okay? Now I know that's gonna be very tough for you guys that are very attached to the girl, connected to that girl. Once you delete all those memories, it's going to speed up the recovery process. So this is how it works from a psychological standpoint, okay? And before we go any further, make sure you press the subscribe button below. Also press the notification bell that'll alert you to my new videos Sunday through Thursday, and also my YouTube live on Sundays at 4 p.m. Eastern time. When you delete all memories of this girl, here's what's happening. There's a riverbed of attachment. So it's formed upon frequency and recency. So the more often you see this girl and the more recent it is, that's going to deepen the amount of the riverbed, and that's going to increase the amount of attachment. So when you break up with that girl, seeing her less often and thinking about her less often is going to speed up the recovery process. So what does that translate to in a practical way? It translates into deleting all pictures of her. It translates into deleting all social media presence. So if you are friends with her on Facebook, delete that so you're not seeing her pictures and her updates. If your friends are on Instagram and Snapchat, remove that so you're not seeing updates about those things. And you don't want to be seeing updates about anything, basically. And you don't want to be in contact with her, so you're seeing her going out with other guys or her having fun without you and not being sad, okay? So when you delete all these things, it's going to allow you to recover as fast as possible. Why is that? You're going to be reminded of her a lot less frequently. And you're also going to be not having to deal with seeing all these different social media things going on with her. Each time you see a picture or something happening with her, that's going to reactivate all those neurological pathways, and it's going to re-stimulate all your attachment and your feelings about that girl. Okay? So do yourself a favor, block the contact, block her email, block her social media, and just go on with your life, okay? And you should also be going out with other girls in the meantime, going out with other new girls. If you decide to keep stalking her social media or talking to your mutual friends and finding out what is going on with her and who she's going on new dates with and different things like this, it's going to cause a perpetual cycle of not getting over the girl. You're going to find out, okay, she's gone with this guy, or okay, she's doing this fun thing with the girls night out, and she potentially likes this guy, and that's going to really bother you, and that's going to really get to you, and that's going to cause you to be in this perpetual loop where you are attached to her and where you can't get over her. Now, another common pitfall that guys make is they marginally justify staying with a girl for just a little bit longer. Okay, some of you that are watching this can relate to this. The problem is that you have a whole bunch of pressure from your family, from your friends that are getting married. Your family wants you to have grandchildren, your friends are all getting married as you reach a certain age. A lot of them are starting to have families themselves. And you're starting to wonder, oh no, should I commit to this person who I've spent a bunch of time with? Now, the typical formula that I've seen before people embark in a marriage or an engagement is they've spent 1 or 2 years with a person, they're not really meeting many new prospects anymore, many new potential dating options, because they are more focused on their careers. Okay, they're not really going out to bars and nightclubs anymore. They're starting to get older. And they have this pressure from their parents to have grandchildren and from their friends who are all getting married and having kids that they should get married too. Okay, so the person starts to think, oh, well, I guess this is good enough. Okay, they start to settle. I guess I'm not gonna really meet something much better than this in the near future. Or they think of it from a perspective, which is a flawed perspective, that particular person is good enough for them and they don't want to hurt that person. All right, so I've seen this many, many, many times amongst my clients. I've even been in that situation myself where they don't want to hurt the person. So if you spent like a year or 2 years in a relationship with a person, you don't want to just toss them to the fucking curb. You don't want to just toss them to the trash. You are into that person. Okay, even if you've kind of moved on past the relationship, you are into that person. You don't want to just toss that person away to the side. And the issue is that it might be totally over, like psychologically, like it's totally done with that person, but you don't want to just toss them to the side because you spent time with them, you've invested time with them, and you like them. And so therefore you're like, okay, I should probably stay with this person, or I should at least give them a chance, or maybe things will get better, or maybe I will reignite my attraction to this person. But more often than not, you won't. More often than not, you're just going to be, what you're doing based on that situation is you're marginally justifying spending a little bit more time with this person that you used to like and that you used to have a bunch of attachment to, and you're going to be putting in a little bit more time that's going to lead that person on further, and it's going to end up hurting that person much more in the long run and hurting you much more in the long run. And what I've seen in most cases is guys will rationally justify this stuff to propose to a girl like this. Okay, and then what happens? Then you have a baby with that girl, and then you are invested financially, and you're invested in terms of all these other things going on in your life, and it wasn't done for the right reasons. The quickest way to get over a girl in 2019 is you want to cut all contact. You want to stop texting. You want to delete her on all social media. Any mutual friends that are telling you updates about that girl's life, you want to cut them out, and you want to, in particular, tell those people, I don't want to hear about this girl anymore. If they continue to tell you about that girl, you want to cut those people out too. You have to be prepared to cut off mutual friends. You have to be prepared to let go of the mutual friendships. Once you do that, it's going to stop activating those pathways, and time will heal everything, I promise you. So as sad and as callous as this whole explanation seems, this is the quickest way to get over a girl, because I can tell you, I know firsthand from doing it myself, and I know firsthand from seeing my clients many times, is that when you continue to think about that girl, when you text with that girl, when you look at her pictures on social media, when you interact with that girl, it's going to remind you of all these good times you had before. It's going to stimulate all those neurological pathways again, and you're just going to stay in this perpetual state of being stuck, and you're never going to really get over that girl. Okay, and you're not gonna be able to move on and date new girls and move on as a person. So make sure, again, it sounds very callous, but make sure if you want to move on, if that is your planned goal, that you want to block her and just cut off all communication and stop being reminded of her, okay? So in summary, don't be one of those guys that takes the next step to get engaged for the wrong reasons. You don't want to just propose to a girl because you've reached X amount of time and you are above a certain age and all your friends are getting married and your parents are pressuring you to have grandchildren. You want to make sure this is the right girl and that you're not blindsided by emotion. So I had 5 separate situations where I had monogamous girlfriends that I was very seriously considering proposing to, and I didn't actually propose to them. And after the emotions cleared and the dust settled, so to speak, I was like, oh my dear God, how could I have ever considered proposing to those girls? But the way that it works neurologically is that you have this extreme attachment, you have this bond where you think this girl is like the perfect girl in the world, and then once you spend a little less time, once that riverbed kind of becomes more shallow, so to speak, in the analogy that I gave before, then she is no longer that important to you and she's no longer like the girl of your dreams. So that is a word of caution to you guys that are watching this, to my viewers. Do not get so wrapped up in a particular girl that you think this is the only girl for you. There are plenty of girls that are more hot, that are more cool. Okay, if monogamy or lifelong marriage or whatever is your ultimate goal, make sure you seriously consider things without this blinder on where you have this neurological attachment and you think this is the only girl for you. I want to encourage you guys to like the video below if you found this useful. Make sure you subscribe, press the subscribe button, and also press the notification bell. That will alert you of my new videos between Sunday and Thursday, 5 days a week. and also my YouTube Live Sunday at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time, this is John Anthony. Take care. Thank you.